Welcome back, Taffers. In this episode, we're finally paying off 4 or 5 episodes of collecting talismans. And now we're going to get the eye in what I think is one of the scariest missions, for me anyway. And this is going to be kind of long, so we're just going to jump right into it. And we're going to try to take as many shortcuts as we can. So we're going to load it. And then restart in 3, 2, 1.
With the talismans, I'll be able to break the wards on the cathedral. It's time for me to retrieve the eye and bring it to Constantine. Last time I was here, the eye was inside, in plain sight on the main altar. I just have to grab it and leave. But that won't necessarily be easy if the place is as haunted as it looked before. So if things get tough, there is another way out. Through the gate in the cloister, behind the cathedral. The sooner this ordeal is over with, the better. When I get paid for this job, I'm gonna retire in style.
All right. Very simple objectives, but you know it's not gonna stay that way. And I kinda like to load this out for war. So we're gonna take all three of those. Gonna take one of those, maybe two. May have to put one back. I'm not sure. I want a healing potion, a couple of fire arrow. Oh, sorry, water arrows. Maybe a rope arrow. Definitely need a fire arrow or two. And I feel like I'm missing something really important, but I don't know. We'll grab a couple of these, and we got enough for another water. We'll just make do with that. And here we go. So we just put the talismans in these holders, but the eye is going to talk to us.
So, you are returned with the talismans, you clever man. I did not think it likely that you would succeed.
Where'd it go? Okay, there we go. Now, in the original game, if you were lucky, you could grab that skull and drop it and prop those doors open, and you could skip like 2/3 of this mission. But they fixed that, Thief Gold. You can't do that anymore. You want to go to the left. Do not go through the main doors. Your death awaits you through the main doors. I don't know who is after us. That's probably talking. And not listening well enough. We pretty much have to sneak our way around. until we can get our hands on the eye. And these doors will automatically close behind you, which just makes things even more unnerving. I'm going to save right here, because we'll often get caught. By a zombie up here. So once you go up the ladder, go through the door, take a right. If the coast is clear, there's a little hammer in the window. This is where we're going. Eventually is the other side of the room. Eventually. Again, I'm going to save it. Let's see if the coast is clear. It is, and that's unusual. So I don't know where that zombie went. I guess the zombie that was fussing at us earlier was up here. Anyway, grab that vase. You can come in here. Oh. I'm not even gonna move. Man, I'm the luckiest ever. There was no skill there. That was just pure dumb luck. Alright, we wanna go up these stairs to the top floor where you should be safe. Eventually. We're gonna come up here several times. There's boxes we need. There's a door we can't open till the very end. And of course, nothing is going to follow you across here. So just come across here. You're safe here. Unlock this. And we're going to get about half our loot in this building. A little bit. Another little bit. Stuck. Go across here. I'm staying crouched most of the time. Is that even locked? It's not. Okay, that was dumb. Because you can still be seen. And I don't want that. Couple water arrows. We're gonna go across here, pick up that diamond. Now this door is locked. Okay, up here's a vase, and we see this is not something that's going to attack you. This is poor Brother Martello, who died up here in the zombie apocalypse, and we're going to help him out. And it's not going to seem like it, but we're going to help him out by tossing him on the ground here, down there on the first floor. All right, you want to save here. Because we're real close. We're fixing to get the eye. So, save. Make sure I'm crouched. And then step off into the dark over here. Okay, make sure you're crouched again. Save. Come over here. Unlock this door. As quickly as you can. Back here's a little note about using the cloister gate, which that will be our exit. And there's the eye. So there is a method to the madness. I'm gonna save it. And so I don't trust myself jumping out there, so I use a rope and I shoot the rope right in that second wooden area. Just like that. And then I'm going to save it again. And then I'm going to jump to the rope. And then onto the big hammer. But then don't grab the eye. We want the eye to bring everybody close to us. I don't know. He's hard to hear when everybody's going bonkers. But he says something. I'll explain it. Okay, this guy I'm going to take out with some fire arrows. He's the only one that can hit you right now. If you stay crouched, you'll avoid most of his shots. Second one. Get out the flash bombs and drop one. Drop another. Right, he's gone. Now, I'm going to scroll through here and find my landmines. There's one. And I'm going to toss it out there towards those guys in the back. That's not bad. So I can set it off. Okay. That's good, because we want to take out these red guys. If at all possible. What do I have left? A couple of those. Let's see. You don't want to aim at them, because you'll throw it over their heads. So aim down. Oh man, that's perfect. That didn't set off the... Come on. Fine. Okay, I'm not worried about the zombies. I'm worried about that guy. Let's see if... That's a long shot. Oh, man. That's perfect. If I can hit it. Body might be in the way. Bingo. We need to get this guy to come over here by us. Alright, equip your water arrow. And we're going to jump off to the left. We're facing the main area. To the left, there's a door down on the ground. We're going to go through that door as fast as we can. And grab the holy water. Use it. He's going to wake up. He's toast. Let's see if we can grab that guy. Got him. Now, when you go through this, if you encounter... Oh, I'm sorry. If you take any damage, go back in this room where we picked up the holy water, and this font... Or fount. I think it's a fount. You can click on it, and it will raise your health immediately, like 4 or 5... little marks, and it will recharge in about 5 minutes, and so you can come back and use it as often as you want. We're gonna pick up Martello, take him again. If we're facing the whole room here, take him through this right door. This is the exit to the cathedral. And it also has the staircase. We're gonna go all the way up. And grab a box. We need some of these boxes on the bottom floor. Measure. Okay, and so I'm just going to crouch, drop down, and crouch, drop down, and then I think this door opens. Did we come this way? We did. All right, we need to go to the other side of the room. Obviously, I'm taking the box. Okay, we need it for in here. So there's just a note where they talking about the weird behavior of the eye. There's a cup on the floor. We need this box to climb up on and jump to the edge. And in the corner, you see it lighting up. It's a necklace. It's super hard to see. Now there is a reason later we're going to be asked to wipe out all of these guys in the red, the haunts. So that's why I declare war in this room. The others we're going to have to be a little bit more strategic and stealthy about. But now we're going to go down the basement. That's where the only guys are left if you took them all out in there. There's a zombie and a ghost or spirit, or I don't know what they're called, down here at the bottom. Just get in the dark and move quiet. We have to do this the old-fashioned way. He might come back. And he might not. This hallway makes a big loop. Use this. Oh, here he comes. Oh, there he goes. Makes a big loop all the way around and through here. Those two guys bump into each other, so you never really know which way they're going to be going, which way they're coming from. We're just going to maneuver around the zombie, but I want to take out the ghost. When they're close together, though, that's not good. Okay, this will work out well. Even if they bump into each other. What? When you attack the ghost, you want to get right up in his face as close as you can get. Because he does not have a melee attack. He has a ranged attack. And sometimes he will fire it off behind you because you're so close. Right. That will probably make the zombie angry. So let's see which way the zombie comes from. Okay, there he is. Let's go. We'll come back to this hall. Run in here. See this barrel? Get up to the barrel and then lean. Don't step over here. There's a trap. And over here is another water arrow. Back here is the other candlestick. And then we're going to run through here. And we're going to go back here. And there's a lot of money back here. I don't know what this does. We're going to open it. There's two silvers over here. I've put stuff in there. Nothing happens. I don't know. Okay, zombie incoming. When you come in this room with all the machinery, flip the switch on the wall. Then hightail it out. That's a bathroom. We don't care about the bathroom. Okay, we're going to go back down this hall again. See, that's where we got the candlesticks. But this time we're going to go down this hall to the left. This takes us to the wine cellar. If the zombie's chasing you, just run around that loop until you lose him. Three wine bottles. 11:26. We've cleaned out the cathedral. But here is Brother Renault. And we're going to help him out of here, too. Heading back toward these pillars. And you want to take a right. You don't want the zombie to chase you while you're carrying that guy. And that switch on the wall, that turns on the lights. Don't turn that on. But you can't outrun the zombie if you're carrying somebody. So we're going to bring him up here. And it's time to introduce you to the other main character of this episode. Besides the eye. Come out the door, close it, get right in this corner. Because it's dark here. When it's clear, come up here, get close, and then go back.
Welcome to the majestic and splendid Hammer Cathedral. How pleasing to welcome new initiates into our fold. I am Brother Muris, and I will be thy spiritual guide. I see that thou art tired from your journey, so I'll leave thee be. But if thou needst my help, I can be found down in the cloister.
Right. Brother Muris is our way out. But it is not safe to move yet. If I attack one, I'm going to get attacked by everybody, and I won't survive. I should have done it. I'm being too cautious. We'll just save. We'll wait. gonna take out the guy in the red. Just rush up behind him. Like that. And then move him immediately. In fact, I think we'll take him inside. You don't have to put him inside. Just throw him somewhere dark. Our next target's that ghost. Right, and then down here in the water is one water arrow. And if we can lure one or both of those zombies over here, that would be great. Yep, come get me. We're gonna lead him way back here, out of the way. You just want to stay in the light, where he can see you pretty easily. Just keep on going. Right here. He'll collapse. Move away from him as fast as you can. And hopefully he'll stay down. He'll get his friend here. Alright, same thing. Okay. They should stay out of our way, hopefully. Hopefully. Right, we're gonna take a right.
These stairs have seen better days.
And down here is where we want to go. Oh, no, no, wait, 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 wait. You know what we didn't do? Is grab one of these boxes. Almost forgot. All right, quietly crouch.
Aha, our newest acolyte. Thou seems to have gotten thyself into some trouble, hmm?
Get in the shadow.
And from the looks of thee, I'd say thou art used to trouble. Well, I can help thee escape this desolate place, if thou wilt help me with something. Since thou clearly camest here to collect things, thou can start by collecting some things for me. All brothers have rosary beads, so thou'lt need some too. Thou canst borrow mine. I think I left them in my room. I'd remember that it was so nice to look out over the fountain in the garden. So be a good lad and bring me my rosary.
So we have to do a lot of fetching for this guy. And I'm going to drop the box close to this broken stairwell. Like that. Now, he wants his rosary. And it's very dangerous through that little archway, by the way. That's the cloister. We're going to go up these stairs. I think this is called St. Yora's. It is. And we're basically going to play chase with a bunch of zombies in here. We don't have the tools or equipment to take them all out. So go up the stairs. Crouch. Be kind of quiet. Up here on this hammer altar are three water arrows. And this is where it's going to get kind of crazy. I'm going to take a left. It's clear through here. Across the hall. That's junk. Just drop it on the bed so it's quiet. There we go. There's some loot. And now let the games begin. There's nothing in there. Oh. But he's gonna corner us. Just run past him. And take a left at the broken stuff. This may go badly. There's the rosary. The rosary beads. We're gonna run through here. And I don't think there's much else on this floor. There's a door on the floor, which rhymes. The dough on the flow. There is a trap over there, so if you get chased over there, watch the floor. Go this way. Oh, hey guys. And, you know, I'm just leading them around at this point. Getting them away from where I want to go. Which is down the hall and to the left. They're kind of all spread out. That's a dead end. That's fine. I'm just going to run through here again. Oh, no, it's not fine. They may have me pinned. Stairs, take a left, go past that hallway into this little office. There's a vase up there. Come through here and across the hall. Ah, I do that every time. That plate's worthless. This takes us back outside. We don't want to go that way. I'm going to go back in this hallway, and right behind me are going to be two zombies. We need to go in that little alcove on the right. So get as close as you dare. Run back here, and in the back is a golden plate. Alright, and again, let the chasing begin. This is bad. Okay. Alright, I see how you guys are. Let's do this. Let's go out this door. Let's save. Go out this door. And then we're gonna drop down. He's gonna start talking to us. We're not done in there.
Aha, what a wonderful looter thou art. Thou hast found my rosary. I have some other things for thee to do as well. I needs for thou to get a holy symbol. This place is not as holy as it once was, I'm afraid, so thou might have a hard time finding one. Thou canst always make one for thyself in the Tenor Factory. We do it all the time and praise the builder for his works.
Alright. We're gonna go back up in here again, except this time... we're gonna go take this right into the kitchen. There's gold plate on the floor. There's a cup in the fireplace. And then up here is a fire arrow. And I want this rope arrow back because I don't have many of them. Alright, now we're done in here. Now let's get out of here. Okay, so Brother Muris is going to send us on a bazillion errand missions, or errands, and we're just going to try to... You can come back to him after each one, but it's really time consuming. So we're going to try to knock out as many as we can before we go back and talk to him again. Run out here... and in this dark corner, when you hear that, it's quiet. So we are going to make the holy symbol. And it's not in that building. It's in the one that zombie came out of. Right there, that orange brick. Or it's where he's going. We need to go in there. We can get a little closer. When they go in that building, right there, they don't stay in there long. Getting busy in the neighborhood. Save. Zombies.
What?
Oh, man. So I ran toward this door, but then took a right. This is a great hiding place. We definitely want to nail the guys in the red. And I would have got him if it wasn't for that zombie. I got super lucky, but we gotta get these guys out of the walkway. Normally, I would not have taken on that guy in a sword fight. Alright, so go through the hallway, you're gonna take a left into here, and we need the mold that looks like a little hammer. That's the bottom right. And stick it on those little prongs. And pull the left switch. That'll close it. Pull the right switch. And for some reason, after all these years, there's still molten metal in there. Pull the left switch to open it back up. Oops. And here's our holy symbol. Alright, we're gonna clean out this building. There's nothing down there. Come around here and up the stairs. Just follow this walkway all the way to this weird looking thing, which is a drill. And down at the bottom is a silver nugget. It's kind of behind that back leg, so sometimes it's hard to see. Here's another altar, which you can usually find some good stuff at the altars. Then we're going to follow this around. Grab the box. Come to the edge and drop the box. Okay, maybe throw the box at the opening. That worked. And just step off. Duck down. And go out here. Okay, you're safe out here. Whew-wee. There's nothing in this little shed. But drop the box there. It's on the top. There's some loot. And a candle. We need the candle. Marus would send us after the candle later. So we're getting it now. And we are done with that building. We just have the tricky part of getting back alive. Save a drop down. We gotta go all the way down there. To our left is the cemetery. We're not going there yet. They can't come out. Oh, this will work out good. We'll get this guy. Pick him up. Just toss him down here. We'll save it. And okay, let's go. Oh, this is bad. Get stuck on the wall. This could go very badly. Gonna save again. Courtyard. The broken staircase is in there. And this is where I'm going to stop and take a breath. We want to go in that door. Which I think that is St. Janelle's. Or St. Janelle's. I don't remember. Definitely don't want to go in there at the moment. We'll just have to wait. Okay, we're gonna quickly go in here. That guy in the red. He's gonna come right back. Right, on this second pile of stuff is a gold hammer. In this doorway, right next to the entrance, is a stack of coins. We're gonna come back over here. Get in the dark. We're gonna save. And then I like to toss a moss arrow down there. And to get across, oh, not safe. Not safe. I like to put a rope arrow halfway between that metal thing and the wall, like right there. We'll save it so I can jump to that, go down a little bit because we're real close where we want to land, so jump right over. That guy seems to hang out right there. So crouch and drop down. We need that cemetery key. And I'm crouched. I'm gonna climb up here and climb up there. And I'm gonna jump to the rope and go down. Alright, there's a lot of tempting doors here. Don't open any of them yet. One of them's a trap, but it's also the one we need. So again, by the altar, moss arrows. Let's unlock this. And there's a stairwell that goes around the edge. On the first landing are two arrows. But now we just need to go all the way up. Alright, and so what we want to do, it doesn't do anything, is open up the moon pool. Lunar pool. Whatever. And get the holy symbol, and we're going to drop it in there. And now it's a blessed holy symbol. We were going to have to do it anyway. Might as well do it now. You know what I mean? Alright, there's nothing in any of these rooms except for the second door from the left. And there's a zombie in there waiting for us. That was a good hit, man. Alright, we're gonna lead him farther away from the door. On his toes. Alright. Quickly go in here. It's on the floor. A gold hammer. And then we're gonna go in this corner. And jump over to the ladder. Don't fall down like I just did. That was noisy. These little nooks on the side of the halls very helpful. So we're going to use these underground passageways to get everything else we need. Alright, there's a guy in red. He's going to come right toward us and then turn around. Go fast. Alright, pick him up and move him out of the way. Back here is great. On this shelf is silver. On this shelf is a diamond. Back here in the back, the chest, another healing potion. If I was smart, I would probably take the other healing potion, but I'm not feeling real smart right now. Here comes our zombie friend. Alright, while we're here, let's go this way. I don't remember what's up there. Troubles, what's up there? Alright, we'll come back to that. So there's the little storeroom, if you will. We can come back here. I guess we'll go up. Have your sword ready. Don't know what you'll encounter when you get up the elevators. This is a popular door. But in here, some water arrows. Let's have our sword ready. We're gonna go back down. That's just another bathroom. There's nothing in it. Through here. It's perfect. Alright, this room with the gold murals. See at the top, the circles? You want to get up here and push the circle on the far right. If you can. If you can't, you might have to go hide. Can't seem to hit it right now. There. See it lit up? And I hit it. And this gold whatever moves out of the way. So we get some holy water, some arrows, a mine, some more water arrows. That's good. You want to save your holy water and water arrows. And now we just need to get out of here. Well, actually, we're going to go up some of the other elevators. Like this. Thank you. quietly approach this slab and climb up. Duck down out of the way. Because I do hear a zombie in here. Oh. And our worst nightmare. Hear the creepy voices, you can just ignore them. In fact, let's, there we go. Alright, we're gonna run up here, grab that arrow I just threw in there, climb up, get my arrow back, and there's a book up here. A prayer book. We need the book. That's all that's in this room. So crouch, drop down, so that you drop silently. And you know what? Let's just go out this way. I mean, I've done stupider things. This is our eventual exit. If this way is blocked by zombies or stuff, you can go, I don't know if it's supposed to be this way, but you can sneak around back behind the building and go way around if this way is not passable. I think we got everything. We need to nail that other guy in the... that haunt in the red. Zombies may make it impossible. We're just gonna fire. Some shadow. Here we are back at the library. There's some shadow just past it. Okay, let's... see if we got everything for Brother Murus. So we'll go back up here.
Excellent. With that holy symbol, thou art truly a novice of the order. I see that thou hast all of the items we need to perform the ritual of consecration. Meet me at my grave in the cemetery.
Right, before we do that, climb up on the box. Try to climb up here. Sometimes you can run and jump and grab it on the left. If you still have trouble with all those, go back in the door that was around that corner and up the stairs and run through the building up on the second floor and you'll come out that door right there. But we need to come up here and get... and get the two guys. Uh. Alright, so now we need to meet Muris in the cemetery. We have a key. Unlock both doors. And we're gonna try to get all these guys to chase us. There's like three or four here. Chase us, but don't get close to him or you'll trigger his conversation. You don't want to do that. Equip your water arrow, put your holy water, and let's go. Is it twofer? He's behind you. Seconds left. Anybody out here? Nope. Okay. So this is where we came in. I mean, here's the gate where we came in. If you'll go to the right, all the way here on the right, in front of this tombstone, is a hammer. And it just makes a big circle. Go through here and find the room or the area with. There's Brother Marus, so we're going to go over here. Or is it Muris? I think it's Muris, not Marus. Here's the other hammer. And we're at 2126. We have all the loot. Which, I know it's not a lot, but it is what it is. Alright.
Let us begin, my friend. Wave the rosary over my tombstone.
Alright, this is kind of confusing. So you want to take this, and the tombstone will highlight, and just
now place the candle on my tombstone.
If it doesn't highlight, it won't work. But same thing.
Read the prayer of consecration.
O Master Builder, we ask thee to bless our brother who hath died in thy service. Forgive him the transgressions of his living days, and look with favor on his works in thy name. Plumb and plane, fire and forge, purify his spirit, and draw from him all which does not meet thy plan. Take him to serve with thee in thy home, where he may rest in peace eternal.
Touch my tombstone with the holy symbol.
Alright, and we got that blessed earlier.
At last, my prayers have been answered. My soul is finally free. Acolyte, thou hast saved me from eternal unrest, but I need thee to help my friends from life as well. I've prepared their final resting places for them, but I need thee to place their bodies in their graves. The first is Brother Renault. He died in the cellar of the cathedral. Please, go get his body and place it in his grave.
Alright, so now we gotta get those fellers. I didn't even care. Alright. Renault. Oh, you're Martello. You're Renault. Again, again, you can't outrun the zombies while you're carrying these guys. So either dodge and evade and sneak, or go for open warfare like I did.
I do not know who thou art, but by thy hand I can finally depart this earth and go to the Builder's home. It is only fitting that I reward thee. In the winter tunnels beneath the cloister, seek thee a room with a mural on one of the walls. In the upper right-hand corner of this mural, spy out a hidden button. Press that button. Thou hast what thou wilt find there, and my full thanks. Farewell.
Please bury Brother Martello. He died in the cathedral attic.
Okay, after we drop off Martello, that's when, now I forgot his name. That's when we'll find out if we need to go hunt down any more of the red haunts. Because he'll tell us.
Thou hast been a great help to me, friend, and I owe thee great thanks. I wish I could give thee the key to the cloister gate, but that is long lost. Take this key instead. It opens the armory in the attic. There is something up there that a crafty person like thee will find useful. I go now to my rest. Once again, I thank thee.
All right. Yeah, he would have stopped us and told us that we needed to kill all the haunts. But we've done that along the way, apparently. And so he's given us the key to our exit strategy, which is the key to the armory. And so we need to go back up in the cathedral one last time. To the top. Why do I feel like I've done something wrong? Oh, because I didn't go to the top. Go all the way to the top. Okay. And here's a door we saw at the beginning that now we have a key for. And we need this thing, which is a bomb, and we need this fire arrow. Down we go again. Don't forget there's guys in the basement, so don't be too loud if you can avoid it. The library is to the right of the red stained glass dude. And the exit is right by the library. Here's the library, here's the exit. So you just want to drop this right in front of the gates. I go all the way back here where I know I'm going to be safe, which is probably plenty far. You just need the one fire arrow. Aim at the top. and then we're going to cue the most frightening cutscene
in
the entire game.
What do you hope to do with me?
Oh, wait. No, we won't. We'll see our stats, and then we'll see the frightening cutscene. It took a little longer than I wanted.
I can't tell you how pleased I am with you, Mr. Garrett. I simply can't find the words, but perhaps Victoria can help me in that regard. She has such a way with them.
Yes, we are both so very pleased.
Victoria?
Even though the eye is defective.
What?
Victoria is quite right, Mr. Garrett. I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but this eye is completely blind.
It's a rock. It's what you asked for. Am I going to get paid or not?
Of course. Victoria, are you prepared to give Mr. Garrett his compensation?
Bow to the woodsy lord and offer up your flesh eyes so that his eye of stone may see, man fool. Bids he then the spruces to singer him an anthem, and the woodsy lord binders them fleshes to stone.
Did you think those ancient phrases were mere words, man fool? Look at me! I am the woodsy lord, the trickster of legend. If you be thirsty, flesh thing, drink of me. If you be hungry, then feed, for I am the honeymaker and the jacksberry.
He am the leaf that feeders on the fleshed ones, thems that calls themselves builders and wielded up a hammers against him.
My poor Mr. Garrett, you will not live to see the sprawling glory of it. Your sacrifice is not yet complete. Mine lilacs and mine thistle-blades must feed, and I? Stands he then in the greens and festive maw, and speeds he of his judgments upon the weeps and writhing manfolds.
Okay, we're going to end it right there with the cliffhanger. And so Garrett realizes he's been a pawn this whole time for the trickster. So thanks for joining me, and you'll see what happens next in the next episode. So go have fun, and I will catch you next time.